حبيب العدل
كفاية
حسن بقى
كفاية
كفاية
كفاية.
The word kifaya means enough in Arabic. It's the rallying cry at anti-government street protests.
شوف يا مصر ولادك فين؟
Kifaya is also the name of a small but determined group of opposition activists.
My name is Ahmed Salah. I am an activist right now in Kifaya, the Egyptian Movement for Change. What we want simply is democracy. We are not trying to take power. All we want is to allow the people in the street to choose by themselves freely those who would rule them. That's all we're trying to do.
In addition to free elections, Kifaya activists like Ahmed are demanding an immediate end to the so-called emergency law. The emergency law allows the government to jail Islamic militants, but has also been used to detain opposition activists, including some from Kifaya.
I am personally very scared.
Ahmed only wears his Kifaya button in certain situations. He says just wearing it in public is enough to be thrown in jail.
If you wear it around alone, you are risking that you will be put in detention, nobody will know about you, and you're gone. When I have company, I can be proudly having it on my chest. Because then, if they arrest me, somebody can report it to my friends.
احنا النهاردة وصل لنا حالة من التفاعل لم نراها من قبل واعتقد لن نراها في بعد.
This is a kifaya meeting at the offices of a communist group.
انا بساسا كنت رافض ان انا امشي في السياسة بقالي فترة لاسباب فيها وصية والدي اللي كان من قيادات حزب العمل ما امشيش في السياسة يعني.
Ahmed's father spent his whole life in an opposition political party and in the end said he wasn't able to change anything. Ahmed initially took his father's advice but joined Kifaya earlier this year because it isn't aligned with any particular ideology. Its members are a mosaic of the opposition, from socialist parties to Islamic groups.
اهم عقبه قدامنا خوف الناس، الناس مرعوبه يا جماعه، يعني طب يعني احنا عايزين نشوف طريقه بقى نكسر بيها خوف الناس، هنكسر خوف الناس ازاي؟
مش هنطاطي مش هنطاطي.
In order to get its message to the people and break their fear of criticizing the government, Kifaya has been holding almost daily protests like this one in Cairo. Before the protests began this spring, Egyptians were not accustomed to seeing anti-government rallies. Protests are officially banned.
A year ago, if anyone would try to shout anti-Mubarak slogans, this person would go to hell. There is absolutely no way. But we managed to liberate few places in Cairo where we can stand and we can say our opinion. There seems to be a very strong similarity between what we are saying, that what we want, and what the U.S. administration wants, or at least says that they want. But there is a very strong lack of confidence here.
Kifaya activists like Ahmed say they don't believe President Bush when he talks about spreading democracy in the Middle East. Ahmed cites America's long support of the Mubarak government and says the U.S. is not pushing Egypt hard enough towards democratic reform. At this rally, a group of Mubarak supporters showed up. As the two competing groups marched down opposite sides of the same street, a few people joined in to sing Kifaya's now familiar theme song. But organizers hope more people would have joined the march.
I think Kifaya people are misjudging their power. At the same time, they are suffering from groupthink. They sit with each other, they are very enthusiastic, they are very fiery, so they imagine that's the case of the country.
Although Kifaya rallies have only been drawing a few hundred people, Ahmed insists the group represents the viewpoint of a majority of Egyptians.
Participation is still little. People are scared for what will happen to them and their families.
Allahu Akbar.
Right now it is to live or to die really for this country, and we have to stop what is going on within the next year or two. Otherwise, this country would really go down the drains.
Allahu Akbar.
Click on an opposition group to continue.